Man, something happened today. Something wonderful. My dad took me and my bike in this pickup truck to the bicycle shop, and we left it there, locked it up, gave that gate so that Riverside Bicycles to space, and he dropped me off at the Ruby Tooth so I could use their Wi-Fi. Well, while I was there, I noticed these two women, and I think they're a man and a little boy who looked like I used to look when I was 3, 4, and they were playing with some balloons. Didn't pay much attention, I just noticed them. Well, it was about getting about time to go to Tinstonian and eat my free meal. 7:30, they closed at 8. And so I was walking. As soon as I got up, I saw my vision, having a visual disturbance while I was walking in the parking lot. Unpleasant feeling in my head right here. The beginnings of the congestion in my ear, feeling like half dead, half alive. But anyways, I heard somebody calling out to me. She had to call out twice. I realized finally she was talking to me. I'm feeling like crap now. I turn around and she's like, "Do you need a ride? If you're willing to wait for us to finish it, even we'll give you a ride." It was a lady. I don't know, in her 20s. Mid to late 20s, maybe. And I'm like, "Oh, thank you." But I had called Monica at Kinstonian and earlier at my house, and she said she would give me a ride home. So I told her I was going to eat my free meal at Kinstonian, and I had a ride there. Thanks. And so we walked away, and I went into the Kinstonian, but Monica was not there. She had left. I got the thing. I was off the ride home. I wanted to ride these people because, you know, that was really precious. They offered me a ride home and I told them no. So I got my meal to go, squashed some vegetables on my plate, then just dumped them into my to-go styrofoam container, took my tea with me, took my computer with me, walked back to Ruby Tuesday, went inside, and after the ride, if the offer was still open, she's like, "Sure." We talked. Her name was Renee, and I was thinking, at first I thought, well, it made me feel really good about myself, because I thought why would she offer me, a complete stranger, a ride when she does not want to know me from Adam? I thought maybe, just maybe, she looked over at me and saw someone she thought was a young kid. And the fact that she would offer me a ride. She had two children with her and her mom. Her children were 3 and one of them was in a, what you call it, cradle. Or a baby, something like, probably a year old, maybe. And she put, the fact that she would offer to give me a ride, she felt totally safe with me in the car, a complete stranger. Made me feel so good. Or maybe it was just, they still believed in neighborly kindness. I don't know, but I feel good about myself today. Wow, they even drove me to get a cup of coffee at McDonald's, and I was about to pull my debit card out, and the mother in the back seat said no. She pulled out $2 and she paid for my cup of coffee, and I was prepared to pay for it myself. They were from Kansas. They live here now, and they said I had some, what did they think about kissing? They said it's rough. But if you see this video, thank you for giving me the ride. thank you, Renee, and your her mother, and your two kids. We were talking about her husband. She's like, I could not live without him. The love she felt for her kids and her husband was wonderful. Made me happy. And the fact that she would offer me a ride, but she, at first, the thought came, oh, she probably knows me. And I felt manipulated, and I asked her, what I knew from? She's like, you don't. I've never met you before. So, wow. The fact that she felt completely safe around me, a complete stranger, means that I'm not some horrifying, monster-looking man. Maybe, I could be wrong. She thought, saw me and mistook me for a young kid. That would be really great either way. But anyway, either way, whether she did or not, she offered me a ride. That's the most important thing. That human kindness, that neighborly kindness. I quoted from her when I saw in the Dukes of Hazzard when Uncle Jesse, played by Denver Power, once said, a stranger is just a friend you've never met before. Thanks, Renee. Hope you and your family have a long, happy life. And God truly bless you. And please don't forget to pray for me. Because I'm feeling like crap right here, right now. Stuff like this makes me want to keep on living. In spite of these. Damn, I don't know what is wrong with me.